okay?
Yeah, I think I'm fine. I'm all right.
I'm gonna call 911.
Honey, that's not necessary. It's not necessary.
Hi, yes. I'm at Memorial Hospital parking garage. There's been an accident.
Hey! Lay off the horn!
I'll take you inside and have you checked out.
Bob!
Don't argue with me. I almost lost him a few months ago. I'm trying to take a chance.
Oh, why is he doing that?
Whoa. Where the hell do you think you're going?
To the airport.
You just hit someone. She could be hurt. She's the chief of staff's wife.
Then they'll run 100 tests she doesn't need for free and confirm what I can already see from here. She's fine. Now get out of my way.
No, you are not going anywhere.
What can I do for you, sweetie?
Dr. Oliver isn't interested in performing surgery on me, so I just need to get out of here.
Okay. I'll tell your boyfriend as soon as he gets back.
Oh, no. I'm not going to wait for Luke. If you could just give me whatever forms I need to sign and call a cab for me, I really appreciate it.
What are you going to do? String me up in the town square?
Look, you caused an accident. You could have seriously injured her. You almost wrecked my car, and all you're worried about is catching your flight?
You know, the whole reason this accident happened is because of you.
Oh, you think this is my fault?
You kidnapped me. You flew me out here on your daddy's jet, chained me to your boyfriend's side to perform a surgery most people I treat wait over a year for. So, yeah, this is your fault.
Luke, honey, let him go. It's not worth it. It's just my neck is a little... I don't
see. Stay. There you go. One good day at a spa, be like nothing happened.
Officer, this man hit her car, and now he's trying to leave the scene of an accident.
For the love of
you can pray in your own time, pal. License and registration, please.
Do me a favor. Could you just pull out your gun and shoot me? Look, Officer Fife, or whatever your name is, I'm really sorry about this whole mess. I'm a neurosurgeon. That means I operate on brains. Okay, I'm based in Dallas. I have to catch a plane to get back to my patients, people who actually need me.
License and registration?
Give him the registration.
Whose car is this?
Well, it's mine, but you didn't buy it.
You lent it to him?
No, I told him that he couldn't borrow it, but he snaps the keys and he took it anyway, which is basically stealing.
No way, just a damn it. I didn't steal your car. You knew exactly where I was going.
Without my permission?
I don't need permission. I'm trying to catch a flight. Seriously, you're giving me a ticket?
Oh, that looks like a summons to me.
Oh, you forgot to add littering. I don't have time for this.
Too bad, because now you're under arrest.
My lawyer is going to have your job.
What does it say?
Driving with an expired license, operating a stolen vehicle, attempting to leave the scene of an accident, and
resisting arrest.
Don't!
No, it's me.
Look, I know it's you. I can button my own shirt.
Well, I know you can, but...
I said no! I may be blind, but are you deaf? Just... stop hovering.
Okay, well, something happened to my car. I'll explain on the way, but we have to get a cab.
I already told the nurse to call me a cab.
All right, well, then that's...
No, I told her to call me a cab, Luke, not us. I just need to get out of here.
Okay.
And... I need to get away from you.
This is really frustrating, but I think it would help if you didn't take everything out on me.
I'm just trying to be honest, Luke.
And honest is saying that you want to get away from me.
Luke, Dr. Oliver was it. He was my last chance of being able to see again. And it's gone.
He was an arrogant, selfish jerk, Noah. And I refuse to believe that he is the only doctor in the world that can perform this operation.
Just stop it, Luke!
Stop what? Stop what, Noah? What am I doing that is so wrong? I'm just trying to help. Why can't you see?
Why can't I what? Why can't I see that? That's what you're gonna say, right? Why can't I see that?
Well, that's not what I meant. I'm just...
boyfriend out.
You know, your way of helping is taking me back to your mommy's house and give me tea and cookies and making sure my socks match
for
the rest of my life.
You know what? Can we not do this right now?
Don't tell me how I feel. Don't tell me what to feel. I'm the one whose eyes don't work anymore, okay? Not you. You have no idea what I'm going through, how I feel, the kind of disappointment that I'm feeling right now because the one doctor I thought could help me stormed out of here, and mostly because he can't stand to be around you.
Okay, now how can you turn this around on me? Like this is all my fault.
This is just what I'm stuck with. Well, I know you think that I feel stuck too, but I don't. Please, Luke, don't tell me that I'm the same Noah you fell in love with, because I'm not. I know I'm not. And you know what? That is what matters most. Noah. You can't really believe that my feelings have changed for you just because you can't see.
I know things have changed for me.
What does that mean? Does that mean that your feelings for me have changed?
Luke, I lost my sight. I mean, how can things be the same between us?
Well, I know that things have changed. But you and me?
No. They've changed because of it.
But we don't have to.
Yes, we do. I mean, you want me to be the same, but I am not the same.
Why? Because you can't see how good looking I am anymore. Noah. There is no way that I can know what you're going through. And I hate that you're going through it. And you say that nothing will ever be the same. And you're right. A lot of it won't be. But this was. What is this saying? You are still the same wonderful guy that I want to spend the rest of my life with. Do you hear what I'm saying, Noah? Do you hear what I'm so desperately trying to tell you?
I hear you.
Good.
I just wish I could believe you even half as much as you believe yourself.
Seems you've run into some trouble in Oakdale, Dr. Oliver.
What I've run into is a confederacy of idiots. Lots and lots of idiots, with a couple of jerks sprinkled in. Your doctors went to clown college. Your cops are dumber than rocks, and that's a medical diagnosis. I didn't steal any car, okay? All I was trying to do was to get to the airport so that I could get back to Dallas. I was strong-armed into coming here by one Luke Snyder, who was one of the jerks that I mentioned. When I didn't agree to operate on his boyfriend, he had me arrested and detained. And now whatever chance I have of getting on a flight today is ruined. So look, I'd appreciate it if you could just save us both a lot of aggravation. Let me have my cell phone back so I can at least try to book a seat on the next flight out of this town that time forgot.
Are you telling the court you're leaving Oakdale,
Dr. Oliver? As fast as I possibly can, Your Honor. Yes, if I could flap my wings and bust through your ceiling, already be on my way.
You realize you've just told me you're a flight risk?
Are you kidding me? Where am I? What is this horrible rabbit hole that I've fallen down?
You've remanded into custody until trial next month.
Next month? Are you out of your mind? You can't do that.
Your Honor, may I approach the bench?